When I think about most memorable year, I don't know if I necessarily have a year.
When I was 11, I developed two incredibly rare neurological conditions. They targeted my brain and my spinal cord. Basically, my body started attacking itself.
She started to decline very quickly. She was in a wheelchair. She was having trouble swallowing, and I could see in her face that she didn't know who I was.
I went from being a normal, happy kid to a complete vegetable. I was having seizures every 2 to 5 minutes.
It was horrible. I mean, as a father, when you can't protect your child.
One of my first memories of being locked in, this doctor basically said, "She's not going to make it. You need to accept the fact that your child's going to die." I just wanted to scream. At that moment, I decided that I'd be damned if this is how my story ends. In 2010, I started to get my hands back, my talking back, my ability to sit up and hold my head up, but the only thing that didn't come back was my legs.
Tell me about life in a wheelchair. What is it like?
I rocked it, but you know, it was a reminder of where I'd gone through. It was like a beacon. I couldn't get over it. I was told by every expert that I would never walk again, but I was also told I would never talk again and move again and let alone live. So I refused to give up.
I would describe Victoria as one of the most determined people I've ever been around.
Shoulder, that was better!
During our first training session, she told me that she wanted to be the first person in the wheelchair to be on Dancing with the Stars. My reply was, why do it in a wheelchair? That was our goal ever since.
To say that I'm proud of Victoria would be an understatement. She gets on something, she just goes, and she doesn't stop.
It took me 10 years to get back what was taken away from me. This is the first year that I finally can just live.
Have you been in it since?
Not really, no. I don't like to sit now that I can stand.